Morning, everyone. Turn with me to 2 Corinthians 4 in your Bibles, and I'm going to pray. Father God, we ask now that as we come to your word, you might help us to see the world as you see it. In Jesus' name, amen. So 2 Corinthians 4, and I'm going to read verse 16 through to verse 18. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. For what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. And we're thinking today about a perspective in lockdown. And there's been a lot of talk, of course, about coronavirus helping us to put life in perspective. After all, if you've got your health, that's really what matters. Get perspective on these things. There's been a lot of talk about the Premier League and Test cricket returning. And yet amidst all the chatter, the stars, one by one, have been quick to remind us that actually it's just a game. Let's get life in perspective. So presumably we've all got life in perspective, right? Yeah, me neither. I don't know about you, but I've found there have been days in recent weeks when I have not had life in perspective. And as lockdown has continued, my lack of perspective has impacted my mood, my emotions. And there have been days when I've begun to lose heart. You see, lose perspective and you lose heart. Lose heart and you just want to quit. Well, let me encourage you today that if that's how you're feeling, that is very normal in the Christian life. And this is where Paul's words to the church in Corinth are really helpful, because they help us to put our troubles and the trials of this life into perspective. And Paul does it through a series of contrasts. Have a look with me at verse 16. It's the contrast in verse 16 between the outer self and the inner self. Therefore, says Paul, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we are being renewed. The therefore here is referring to the resurrection, which Paul's just been talking about in verse 14. As Christians, of course, we live in the light of the resurrection. We have new life in Jesus now, and we're looking forward to life with Jesus in eternity. And so although outwardly our bodies are aching and wasting away, inwardly, spiritually, we are being renewed as we become more like Jesus. And so whatever your struggles today, whether it's health or weariness or homeschooling has just about finished you off, or it's another round of cooking and cleaning and washing, and it's for people you love, but you'd never quite imagine they'd be with you for quite this long, or whatever it might be, when it all starts to feel like a grind, remember that for all the aches, you are being renewed by the resurrection power of the Holy Spirit. And then look at the contrasts in verse 17, because here Paul takes something light and he compares it with something weighty. He takes something that is momentary and he compares it with something eternal. And he talks about the difference between our troubles in this life and the glory that awaits us in the next. And I don't know about you, but there have been days in this lockdown when my troubles have felt anything but light. And as the days have dragged on, none of this has felt momentary. It's felt unending, and I've been tempted to lose heart. But when I remember the gospel and the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, my eyes are then drawn, my heart is drawn towards the eternal glory that awaits us one day. And as I meditate on that glory, I begin to see that it far outweighs my troubles, and suddenly my troubles get smaller because Jesus gets bigger. And then verse 18, where now Paul contrasts the seen with the unseen, the temporary with the eternal. As Christians, of course, we walk by faith and not by sight. The world, of course, looks at Christians and as we suffer and just laughs. Where is your God? He doesn't love you. He isn't there. He doesn't care. But we know that this world is temporary. It won't last. And therefore, nor will our suffering. Our troubles are momentary. They will pass. And in a world that judges the outward appearance, therefore, verse 16, look to the spiritual renewal that the gospel makes possible within. In a world that can't bear to face suffering, remember verse 17, that when set against the eternal glory that awaits us, your troubles really are just light and momentary. And in a world obsessed with the here and now, remember verse 18, that this world will pass away. There is so much more to come, and it'll last forever. A series of contrasts to give us perspective so that we do not lose heart. And the really big thing here, we'll look again at verse 17. Paul says it's our troubles, the suffering that we go through in this life, that are achieving, can you see that, are achieving this glory for us. It's not that they get in the way of this glory or that they threaten to stop us enjoying our eternity. No, rather, more than that, it's amazing this, God is using them to achieve for us this glory. Because God uses our troubles to make us more like Jesus. Look, we don't have time to get into that now. But it does give meaning, it does give purpose to our troubles. They are achieving for us an eternal glory. If you were beginning maybe to lose heart, why not meditate on these verses today and ask God to give you fresh perspective in the light of the resurrection so that you do not lose heart. Let me pray. Father God, many of us right now, we're tempted to lose heart, and we thank you therefore for your word to us now that gives us perspective, and we pray you'd help us to fix our eyes on Jesus and the eternal glory that is ours through his resurrection, and that as we do that, our troubles would fade so that we would not lose heart. In Jesus' name we pray.